Shalom, Ras Tefri. So let us continue with the presentation concerning the true order of Rastafari. But let us bring here's the comment that Tobia made. And we do apologize because there's a few corrections we do have to make. And first of all, we never intended for anyone to believe that that what we said was exactly what Tobia had presented. We were just like kind of going off memory, but we assure that we weren't trying to put words in his mouth that weren't there. I mean, we didn't use the exact same words, but we didn't go beyond that which was actually presented. But here's the comment that I was actually referring to. And it's a good thing we went to it because I have to apologize and make a correction. But nonetheless, you think that your friend from EWN capitalized, that means dead, like capitulated or least common denominator, that makes that corporation like that's what full caps means. It's a capital punishment, right? So that you're considered like a dead entity, dead property, or whatever. So EWN did not make those threats against me. I still don't know where and when or how EWN threatened Tobia. But nonetheless, you think that he did talk about you think that he did talk about people getting shot because they approach people in the wrong way? Here's where I apologize. I do recall Brother Yadon mentioning the situation with who was it? The Snoop Dogg and or excuse that Snoop Lion and that whole incident, but that was an example. I mean and it wasn't like I guess we could even go as far as saying it's a warning. My bad. It's a warning, don't in certain areas people go people react in such a way. Not to say that we will, but it's more like a I would take it as a warning. It's like that's true. I need to at least tame the mouth and know when to say these things. But then again, the warning being presented can be received to its fullness when you understand that you cannot change from 1 minute to another. A lot of people go into prison in this manner. They're shady people, all right? No values, no morals, and because you could break the so-called law and you could still be an honorable son of the Almighty. It's just that in a dishonorable system, well, who knows? I mean, anything's possible, right? But nonetheless, many people commit the mistake of thinking that, oh yeah, well I'm this way, but if I get thrown in behind bars, I'm gonna change. I'm not gonna be that way, and it doesn't happen, And it just does not happen in a lot of people, cause I've spoken to like individuals where I let them know, you better not go to jail, man, because I mean, they're gonna eat you alive, man, and they're as soon as they look at you, like they're not even gonna have to ask any questions. They're gonna know, like these people are locked up all the time. They can read a book, without even. I mean, I guess every rule has an exception, Don't judge a book by its cover. I think in prison, it's like they read through the cover and they go to. I mean, they read the whole book, right? And so I let certain people know, don't go to jail, man. Just don't go, cause you're not gonna last. And so they say, oh, but I'm not gonna be that way. Like, and still at well, at least they admit, right, to their wrongdoings. But they make mention, oh, I like we're not dumb. We're not gonna be like that, and I'll survive whatever. First of all, I mean, it's not a challenge, all right. It's not the best place to be. But even let's say that you do, unfortunately, fall behind bars, you're incarcerated, yeah, you're gonna act you're gonna be a hypocrite like you are now anyways. But then you're gonna forget, and they know that you're gonna be a hypocrite. Believe I They know that you're gonna play the part, but they're gonna be waiting for you to slip because they know that you're fake. I mean, they could smell it, they can see it, they can feel it. And so they're just gonna wait for you to be fake. And then as soon as you slip, you're done with, you know? It's whatever little excuse they can take, they'll take it. So they wanna have fun, you know, they're bored. And well, I say that because cons you know, to the reference of some people get shot, you know, doing stuff like that, take it as a warning, you know, it's a good thing. And don't think that you can change from 1 minute to another. It takes time and practice, you know, let us we change at a slow pace. And so don't ever make the confusion the don't me ever make the mistake or of pretending or assuming that you can be someone else, like from sunrise to sunset. So yeah, I mean, that was kind of like off topic, but it's still good advice, I would say, you know. So there are videos that he has made about me. Here's that pride again, you know, it's me. Not really, the videos just happen to give an opportunity to make mention of not you in particular, but the situation, to warn others not to be like the situation. Even in that statement, we are not going to allow the me to take credit of anything, but of nothing. It don't exist. So let us continue. There's nothing for you to think about. All you have to do, see, that's here's where the demonic entities seek domination. In using leadership as an excuse, and seeking to control the world and the mind and the thoughts of other individuals, not allowing free will. We Rastafari, one thing that we know is that our Father allows free will, and we are going against our Father by not allowing ones to make up their own decisions. So, yeah, totally against that, Rastafari is. Now, continuing, all you have to do is go on his page and listen to the videos. How is it that you are making videos about a subject that you are not familiar with? Do you really think that makes sense? Yeah, I'm not gonna go into that, but so yeah, basically, the only thing we have to add is that, yeah, that's true. Our brother Yadon did mention the Snoop Dogg case, but it's a warning, you know. So yeah. Okay, continuing. So let us go to Johannes Wangel, the Gospel of John, chapter 7, and we just wanna, you know, we're not gonna read through the whole thing, although it is necessary. Nonetheless, let us just make mention a few little facts. After these things, Jesus walked in Galilee. The walk. For he would not walk in Jewry because the Jews sought to kill him. So we did some definition search on Jewry, and what we received, and it's not the only interpretation, but Jewry, like to walk in praises. He wasn't trying to be praised of man. He was trying to satisfy his father, as should we. So walk as a jewel, as a jewelry, you know, even it even sounds like that. So Yitzhak did not wish to walk in man's praises. That's what we receive from this in this particular situation. Now the Jews' Feast of Tabernacles was at hand, and actually the Feast of Tabernacles was at hand when this was occurring not long ago, a few days ago. But I just came across the video, and so I'm kind of like I guess I was left behind. So continuing, we wanted to make mention. So his brethren therefore said to him, depart hence and go into Judea, that thy disciples also may see the works that thou doest. For there is no man that doeth anything in secret, and he himself seeketh to be known openly. If thou do these things, show thyself to the world. Yeah, we definitely gotta gotta put everything in context, and honestly, we overlooked that huge detail. But 'cause basically we don't know who's speaking. But nonetheless, no man doeth anything in secret, and he himself seeketh to be known openly. But we do pray to our Father secretly, and he, knowing all things, will provide for us openly. But this has to do with 'cause Quieta Jesus goes to the feast on undercover, you could say. But it, once again, all this does is prove the idea that he's not looking for man's praises and to be praised of man. Rather, he's seeking to do the will of him who sent him, as we ought to do as well. So continuing, for neither did his brethren believe in him. Then Jesus said to them, "My time is not yet come, but your time is alway ready. The world cannot hate you, but it hated me because I testify of it, that the works thereof are evil." We agree. "Go ye up to this feast." I go not up to this feast, for my time is not yet full come. When he had said these words to them, he abode still in Galilee. So the fact that it takes its time, the scripture takes time to recognize that these words in verse 9, when he had said these words to them, he abode still in Galilee. So that means there's something very significant about the words that he has just uttered. And those words were, "For my time is not yet full come." Verse 10, "But when his brethren were gone up, then he went, he also up to the feast, not openly, but as it were in secret." So what is it that was so important about what he said, that they had to make mention what he said, "My time is not yet full come"? And that's referring to Jesus telling the disciples, "You go, like, it's not my time." And then scripture says, points out that verse 9, when he had said these words to them, he abode still in Galilee. And the reason I'm kind of going through this like in great detail is because it'll help ones to study Bible, like it helped that, you know. And so when there's emphasis on something that would seem insignificant, that means it's not insignificant. And let us reveal what it is that we believe is the case of that specification. Verse 10 says, "As soon as the brothers were gone up, then he went." That means that Gietaesus, being the shepherd of the thoughts, you know, as soon as the thoughts went up to the feast, his time was now full come. That made it his business, and therefore he went up to the feast, because now the time has come, because my thoughts are over there, and I am the shepherd, and I must take care, good care of my thoughts. And so, thus revealing that which was so significant. And otherwise, we would have not, these are little clues that we get in scripture. Otherwise, we would have not picked up on that. And so let us continue. So he went not openly, and this is probably even, this probably goes as far as the disciples being like, "Man, I wish Gietaesus was here, man. He'd shut all these people up." And then behold, look and see, Gietaesus, you know, makes himself shown and starts teaching, as it'll go on to say. So yeah, so much murmuring among the people concerning him, for some said he's a good man, others said, "Nay, but he deceiveth the people." That is exactly what the evil spirit in the form of Tobiah has declared. That, like, literally, that Wendemiado deceiveth the people, and that truth must be spoken. Yup. So now, howbeit, no man spake openly of him for fear of the Jews. Now, about the midst of the feast, Jesus went up into the temple and taught. So yeah, and the Jews marveled, saying, "How knoweth this man letters? Have he not learned? Have he never learned?" Because he's the Alpha and the Omega. He is the letters. He is, the letters are his, my bad. Correction. So every one of I and I's sheep thoughts are his. That's why he called us by our name. That makes him have dominion over I and I. Him that nameth, you know, the creature is his creator. And we'll go into that. That actually has to do with Rastafari Sabbath study number one. Bemejemeria. Check out Beruku 1 on concerning that. Really, really good information. Really good knowledge. So let us continue. So let us just spring over to let us continue in verse 15. And the Jews marveled, saying, "How knoweth this man letters, having never learned?" Yes, maybe it's because Geta Jesus didn't have like a bachelor's degree or something like that. Maybe that's what threw him off. So yeah, that I could totally understand that. Jesus answered them and said, "My doctrine is not mine, but his that sent me. If any man will do his will, he shall know of the doctrine, whether it be of God, or whether I speak of myself." That's the slander, the ego and the pride. "He that speaketh of himself seeketh his own glory, but he that speaketh his glory that sent him, the same is true, and no unrighteousness is in him. Seek ye Jah Almighty while he still can be found. I would advise ones, repent. Did Moses not give you the law, and yet none of you keepeth the law? Why go ye about to kill me?" Who is the law? The law is Geta Jesus. "Why seeketh them to kill a promise or a covenant, an agreement? I shall not do this, I shall not do that. Or thou shalt not this, thou shalt not that. And then what did Israel say? I will. That which the Lord has set, we will do." You know, they themselves, you know, put themselves in contract, in a three-party contractual agreement. So, but anyways, you know, Moses gives them the law and they don't keep it. So they kill the law. They kill that trust. So why do they seek to kill Geta Jesus? Why do they seek to take action away from where action is possible? They seek to keep every one of our thoughts and every one of us, every one of the numbered, every one of the letters, they seek to keep them in a state of inertia, in a frozen psychological state where movement is obstructed. But we must go beyond to a position in which such obstruction is not possible, says His Imperial Majesty. And that's referencing His wisdom. Now, continuing, so yeah, if you look up the Blue Letter Bible Dictionary definition for kill in this instance, not the first definition, but the root word of kill in this particular place and time is it's referring to taking, for example, like taking the action out of a verb. So let's say running, they want to take the ing out of running. So to run is well, that's not even a great example, right? But loosening, same deal, you know. What is loose without ing? It's not an action. It is there's no action in just run, but running is putting run in action. You know, that means someone is taking on that covenant and putting meaning and filling it with content and value. So Yeah, basically that's what we wanted to share. And so the people answered and said, "Thou hast a devil who goeth about to kill thee." That's people. That's why we don't debate, because you get people like that in the public. It's like, why do you seek to kill me? What? There's a devil? You got a devil trying to kill you? It's like, who said devil? And where do you get that from? Who possesses your? Who has bewitched you? Anyways, continuing, it reads, verse 21, Jesus answered and said to them, I have done one work I have done, and ye all marvel. And that's what we meant by wandering, marvel, like not wanting to accept it and kind of like overlooking the facts and just kind of like getting stuck in your pride and imagination. That's what we were referring to. So let's see. As far as the whole separating the verb or the noun from action, we want to include that. We don't discuss, because see, dis is no and cuss is profanity. First of all, we don't discuss no profanity. Well, I take that back. We might agree on that, no profanity, but at least debate. And so D is no, and bait is give we just 1 second. We kind of. Forgive we for this, apparently we don't know how to use a dictionary all that well, or else we would have found it. But we're looking for the word bait. Yeah, and it's unfortunate that we weren't able to find it, because that just proves that we are not all that knowledgeable in the usage of a dictionary. Let us hope that we wrote it down. And it appears that we did not. So let us go on forward. Anyways, well, we know what bait is. Nah, that's just what someone would try to use to convince himself that he knows what he's actually talking about. But anyways, what we did want to present was the idea of debate. So whatever bait means, it's no, and then you go on forward to state whatever it means. And but we don't you see, that means no contract. And no contract. Okay, you have to cancel out the con because that also refers to no. So tract. What is tract? A tract is a it's a sign. It's the what do you call that? That's in. It's to be a sign within our foreheads. We are the tract. We are the contract. They would say, right? But more correctly, we are the tract. We are the sign. We bear witness of an event that took place before we are in the now. And so well, that was, I guess, like extra information. But as far as debating and stuff like that, that's all like no contract, no agreement. And so yeah, we do not agree with them, and so we do not discuss, we do not get involved in that, because that is of a mixed up and wicked origin. See, they seek to get the information out of you that they themselves cannot receive, and expose, supposedly expose you in public. But what that will do is put you in a position where a lot of ignorant people that are not knowledgeable in the subject are in a state of emotion where they're excited and they're participating in this debate. And so it's very easy to manipulate weakness, especially under emotional stress, you could say, or in weak-minded people in a situation that stimulates their emotions, it's really easy to manipulate people. And so, for example, that verse right there is like, Getayesus, all he said was, why do you seek to kill me? And someone screams out, I mean, I don't know who it was, but someone out of not the blue, but out of somewhere, they say, thou hast the devil who goeth about to kill thee? And so we gotta avoid that. We gotta not fall victims and not put ourselves in a situation that it's a setup where they set up a debate. And so yeah, I totally tried to save that, but I don't know if one's fell for it, but yeah, let us continue, because we couldn't find the word bait in the dictionary. And so yeah, there's so much in this, but we really want to conclude there to not get into Well, it goes into the explanation of why they don't know. See, because they don't know the Father. It's kind of it's okay. So it says, and this is verse 30. Then they sought to take him, but no man laid hands on him because his hour was not yet come. That means that his days were not yet fully filled, and so he's keeping covenant, because obviously Jah's protecting him, because nothing can happen to anyone if we are in covenant and keeping covenant and walking the walk, until the days of our lives, of our mission or pilgrimage are fulfilled. And so, and many of the people believed on him and said, when Christ cometh, so did they believe in him? Will he do more miracles than these which this man hath done? So yeah, in a little while. So then said Jesus to them, yet a little while am I with you, and then I go to him that sent me. Ye shall seek me and shall not find me, and where I am, thy there ye cannot come. So the Jews murmur amongst themselves, and they're wondering where he's going. Manner of saying is that he said, ye shall seek me and shall not find me. Where I am, thy there ye cannot go. In the last days, that great day of the feast, Getayesus, or Jesus, stood and cried, saying, if any man thirst, let him come to me and drink. He that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. But this spake he of the Spirit, which they that believe on him should receive. For the Holy Spirit was not yet given, because that Jesus was not yet glorified. Yeah, so it appears that we went off track, but nah, it's basically like some of these people that just don't get it is because they might know the Father, but they don't glorify the Son, and so the Spirit is not yet poured upon them. Or they accept the Son and glorify Getayesus, but they don't receive the Father, or don't know with the Father. It's you can't have one without the other. It's got to be in three. And so who's that third entity to make an agreement, that to make it legal and contractual? And so it's the third person taking on the Holy Spirit and making the agreement legit, and therefore stamping it with the mark. And that mark is I and I. We're the mark. The Holy Spirit is the completion of the treaty, of the agreement. And so that's where the whole contract, no tract, but no stamp, no mark, but in reality is mark, so the mark is evidence of that which was agreed upon by the three parties coming into marriage as one. forming one corporation. So, you know, just some of that, to, you know, just putting it out there. So let us conclude with that, and yeah, let us just conclude there. So we give thanks to everyone that participates in these videos, and you know, I hope that it helps some of the people out there, especially brothers and sisters. And let us, you know, let us not deal unwisely on this situation. We gotta remember that Tobia is held captive under a demonic make-believe source or power lack thereof. So yeah, you know, Shalom Ras Tefri.